Hi, we made a small change to the AMI that we use on AWS that we made available to you on AWS. And so I wanted to show you a few, really three changes that you'll need to be aware of as you're accessing the AMI through as you're using AWS. All right, so the first thing to notice or to be aware of is that AWS is split up into regions. All right, so here on the top right of your page here on the EC2, I can even go back here to the EC2 dashboard. You'll notice there are several different regions, 9 different regions spread out throughout the world. So you'll want to choose a region that's closest to you probably. That will work the best for you. Okay, so I'm choosing North Virginia, for example, okay? And now we want to launch an instance, okay? And we go down to Community AMIs. This is just as I showed you before. But because we changed the AMI a little bit, it's going to have a new number. And also, the AMI, each AMI is specific to the region that it's in. So the AMI for North Virginia will have a different number than the AMI for Oregon or Ireland, for example. Okay, so we'll have a list of the regions and their corresponding AMI number on the Coursera website for you. All right, so you'll have to look there to figure out what AMI you'll be looking at. You'll still probably be able to just search for DL2 within that region and select that. But again, if there's more than one DL2 image, or if for some reason in the future we rename the AMIs to something that's not DL2, you can always refer to the Coursera website, look up that AMI number for your specific region, and search for that number, okay? Now the other thing that changed, so those are the first two things to be aware of, the region that you're in and the AMI number. The third thing is that we switched the Linux type for the AMI, whereas before it was an Amazon Linux AMI, now it is an Ubuntu AMI, just like the virtual machine. And so whereas before you were always using EC2 user for the username whenever you were connecting to AWS through SSH, now the username will always be Ubuntu. And we'll have more reminders of this on the Coursera website. But again, remember, whenever you're using SSH to go into AWS for these new AMIs, the username is Ubuntu. And I'll show you an example of where that might come up, okay? So I will go back to my instances. For example, here, I already have one running, and I'll click Connect. And one of the options that I'll be showing you more within this segment is the standalone SSH client, or this Java SSH client. And here, the default username is always root. But again, you'll want to use Ubuntu. And that's the same whether you're using SSH on Linux or Mac, or if you're using PuTTY on Windows to SSH to use the AMI on AWS. Excuse me. Okay, so those are the three main the three things that I wanted to make you aware of: the region, the AMI number, and the username is now Ubuntu. All right.